So the master track, Science for Energy and Sustainability, is really quite special because it's not only a theoretical study, it actually has a goal and it follows the United Nations SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals. And that means that students, they learn a lot of theory and they learn how things work, but they also learn the practice of how it fits with the needs of society and how it fits with economics and how it fits with real life problems. And that's what makes it special. Yeah, so this is a two-year program, and it's a joint thing of the UvA and the VU. So the students benefit from the expertise of both universities. In the first year, there are many courses, and the courses have a lot of chemistry and some physics and also a bit of mathematics and a lot about the social implications and some on the economical implications of sustainability. And in the second year, typically the students do the two projects. We have the short project, what we call the literature project, and then a longer internship project, a research project at one of the groups. Here again, the students can choose the group and it can be from either university. And that's really important because we get varied students and it's really good for the student to be able to choose the supervisor and the type of project that fits their needs.
Well, during my bachelor in chemistry, I could not really see the impact of my studies on the climate crisis and waste of resources. But then I heard of sustainable and green chemistry, and I thought, imagine if we could optimize all the reactions behind the food process and fuels and everyday products. So I looked for a master in sustainable chemistry, and moving to Amsterdam at that point was just a natural choice for me. I did enjoy the flexibility, the freedom of mixing chemistry with other disciplines during my courses. For example, I followed mostly catalysis courses, on top of which I added things like economics of climate change, transition management, photovoltaics. This course is truly interdisciplinary.
The students come a lot from chemistry, some of them come from physics, a few of them come from the beta-gamma track, and some even come from the science, business and innovation track of the VU. The fact that we have so many different students, I think that in the last 2 years this was the most international program that we had, it's really, really good because you get such a good vibe, you get so many different experiences, and people can share this and they work together and they learn together. And actually, that is what is needed because this connection across cultures is where sustainability starts.
An advice to future students is to focus on your studies, but also to enjoy life at the university and in Amsterdam. Sustainability here is a big theme, and there are plenty of organizations, initiatives, and meetups where you can find like-minded people. But also you can grab a better understanding of who are the key players driving innovation on a European level.
The thing is that the world is changing. And if 20 years ago or 30 years ago you needed to be extremely good at what you do and you needed to know great about if it is material science or organic chemistry or chemical engineering or economics or whatever it is, today there is much, much more work for hybrid jobs that require hybrid education. And if we want to solve sustainability problems, if we want to solve big problems like how to do the energy transition and how to combat climate change, we need people that can talk to each other but also understand not only chemistry and physics but also the societal implications and the economic implications. So there's going to be lots of work for graduates of this track because many of these very large projects will need a lot of people that can carry this out.